Hey there. Well, what I thought was just a burnt tail light, well, brake light particularly, was a little deeper than I anticipated. I'll kind of show you your options if you come across this. Ow, just hit my head on the hatchback. We got two screws to take the tail light out. They're Torx bits, like a T25. I'll just pop these out for a second. Right. Now to remove these, don't go pushing it too far that way or prying up or pry down. They basically slide out, and I'll show you what's holding them in so you don't have to be paranoid.
So just kind of, you can help it out a little bit here, but you're basically just pulling out this away.
But basically what's holding it in are just little rubber grommets. Where are you? One and two, and they've just got these little balls. Yeah. So that's all that's holding them in. So just pull them straight out. So once you got all that out, at the bottom here, you got a little blue clip. Well, yours might not be blue. It's got two little tongues on each side. Oops. You can either use your fingers or a pair of needle noses just to squeeze in the squeeze them together, pop them through. That gives you a little more wiggle room here. So here am I on camera. Where am I? Right here. You got a little clip there. Just push in, kind of wiggle yourself on out of there. And then take this with you. Because this is what I'll be replacing. The circuit board. Not this. Okay, I'm going to tell you what the problem is. If I'm focusing, no we're not, of course. Come on. Piece of crap. Under the black, there's like little pieces of copper or whatnot all through here. It's kind of like a circuit board. And it's all rusted to hell and rusted into each other. So you're getting continuity between the parking light and the brake light, which you shouldn't have. My signals are fine, my reverse is fine, but I tried taking this out before, cleaning up the contacts, figuring that would help it all out, but no, I did a continuity test and everything was just wacky. I don't have a scrapyard close, or else I would go and just maybe pick apart and grab that and just replace the whole thing. I don't have one close enough to make it worth my while. But you don't have to replace the whole thing. You can purchase just the circuit board itself. I can leave a link to this particular one if you like. What I like about it, I read the comments and somebody had mentioned that it had the pigtails, which is awesome because that pigtail is just rusted to crap. And I would have had to buy another pigtail to replace that one. And these two probably would have been fine, but this comes with the pigtails. Not too hard to deal with either. Let me just get a tripod. Okay, I'll try to keep my dirty old mitts out of your face. But, let's see. I guess I can show you on this. There's, where are we? Okay. See these, where am I? See these little clips? Or tabs? You got that, and on the other end you got the same things. You don't want to snap those. tabs. See this little pin here? You can push out on that pin, either from the bottom or the top. I'm just doing it from the bottom because I happen to be looking that way. But just kind of push them out one at a time. Mine camera. Kind of hold on to the back and just give a little push. Help if I could see. Just pop it up. And then same with the other side. Much easier if I'm not trying to do this on a YouTube video. I can even do it with my thumbnails, but you're not going to see. So basically, as I see, they just came off. I used my thumbnails, got them in there. It's kind of easier if you can try to get them both at the same time, but if you do one, wedge it, do the other, kind of wedge it, they'll pop off. No problem. But I got these thumbnails that really work well. I'll see if I can... See, I gotta get my freaking nubbies in the way. Let's see. Can you see it? I don't know. Probably not. That's why I can't stand doing repair videos. There's one. Oops, and the other one just popped back in. See, I don't really care about the tabs breaking on this. I would normally just cut that one off, but there. Okay, so now both ends are off. In the center, oh, I broke my nail. In the center, you got these little plastic tabs in the steel press-ons. So just kind of get under them, pop them off. I'm going to break those tabs because I got my other ones there. The steel. Okay, so I bent that over, got it off. And I'll do the same here. There. And it all slides off. Watch out for your little rubber... Oops, where are we? Your little foam, I guess foam. Okay, so now you're left with this. I'll show you, okay, that's my reverse, I'll swap over. That's my turn signal. See, it's not too bad. Reverse wasn't too bad. The insides weren't too bad. And then we get to the brake lights. And it's all, I don't know how well you can see it in there. Maybe this side up. That's just crap. All corroded in together. The fins were all screwed up. So yeah. Take your bulbs. Swap them over. Where's my paper towel? You don't want your grubby fingers on your bulbs. They won't last as long. And the deeper. And the reverse. I'm saying deeper, I'm going to break. Mark, same mark. Reverse the same moment. Okay. Putting it back is a breeze, really. Now it's just a matter of replacing them. Oh. Hey. another nice surprise, if you can see. It comes with its own foam. So you can get rid of this crap. That was awesome. Yeah, I'll definitely leave a link for this particular one because I'm so far pretty happy with it. And it basically just pops in. I would imagine, I think I'm gonna pop these in first. Just kind of squeeze them out a little bit so you can get your tappies in. Okay. Snap, snap. Do the same on this side. Just kind of hold the little tabbies out if you can see in there. Just snap, snap. Did we do a snap on this side? Oh no, they both went. Oh, this one didn't. Snap, snap. And then just push these tabs in. There you go. And then just put it all back. Now, if you want, which I'll probably do, is, hold on a sec. Get some lubricant. Something gooey. I use this for gooey stuff. And just a little squirt. Oops. I got a couple little squirts on the tabs. And that'll help it coming in and out if you gotta change your bulbs later. Back to the Jeep. Yeah, so pretty much putting it all back together is pretty much what you did when you took it apart. I don't know if you can see in the camera there. Just put your clips back on. Make sure they're seated well. This little blue clip at the bottom. Test before I pop everything back in. Make sure everything's working. There we go. I have parking lights. And there's a tennis racket between the brake lights. Do I have brake lights? Ah, yay, we're good to go. Oh, wait, just double check, make sure I got reverse. Good to go. So now that everything is good to go, just pop that back in, screw your screws in, and you're good to go. Thanks for watching. Ciao for now.